This video is about how to design such a cowboy hat, and what we see here, we have at base three sketches. The green one is the sketch for the border of the hat, and the blue and the red one define the height, the silhouette of the hat. Okay, how can we start? We start with another example. This is another model. And what is the beginning? The beginning is we have some helper planes. And in these planes I define some sketches. One sketch for a profile in this direction, the profile in the other direction, and one profile for the border. We see here I hide the planes. These steps all can be done with part design, and I hide this too. So what is the fine structure of the XY sketch? The XY sketch consists of some groups of three points. It starts here, 1, 2. This is the beginning, the first tangent. Then we have the next control point with two tangent indicators here again, and here the same, and here, and here, and here, and here the last but one, and the last point is the tangent indicator from the starting point. This is the structure, and we can change, we can move the points a little bit around. This is not a problem. So, okay, if we have created this sketch, the next step is to create from this sketch a curve. So I select this sketch and say I want to create a bearing. The name of bearing comes from the format. What we see is here exactly a ring structure. So to define a surface, I have to split this ring, in this case, into four parts. This is simply can be done this way, that I say I have such a sketch here, I have a start position, and I say I want only the first two segments, then I have this, and now I can repeat the process three times. The next should begin at 2 and should go to 4, and then I start at 4 and go to 6, and the last one will complete it from 6 to 8. So now we have these sketches you see here in this way. So we also need the curves for the other two profiles, for this one and for this one. So we use them. First, let's see what is the structure of these profiles. In this case, we have a starting control point, the first tangent indicator. We have here the second control point with two tangents, and the last control point with tangent indicator. That's all. The other one has the same structure: start, middle part, and end control point. Okay, we can refine the layout later, and I transform these two sketches to bearings because they have a special structure. I do not get a closed bearing, but I get some curves which consist both of two Bezier curves. We see them here. Here we have a strong corner, in this case it is smooth. So, and now I make them visible, and now to run the Gordon surface on this curves, I have to make first a compound, so I switch back to part and I say I want this one and this one, and then the meridians, this tree, and I make a compound. So, and I go back to NURBS. Having this compound, now I use the method create a garden surface. Okay, and so I get this. I delete it and repeat this action. So, and we see a result where we can see that the direction of the profiles are not in the right way. So at this moment I have to play a little bit with the directions of the components to get better results. I first start, I have three helper surfaces. The first is the U profile, and what I see here is that two profiles are in the right direction and one is switched. So I make them visible and I say, what is this profile? Is sketch bearing sketch 11, and in this case I can switch the direction. So, and now this mapping is correct. This is all right. So I hide this, I look at the V, and we have here the same. We have here that this one is in the false direction. So what curve is it? Is this one? The 10 is in the false direction, but I also can use these two. I can switch these two into the other direction and I get a good result. So now we have these two surfaces have the right format, and there is a third interface surface. This is the S3 interface. This is also in a good layout, and now I can start the Gordon surface. And what I see here is that one of these two has a complete false direction, so I have to change all the profiles of the U or the V Y direction. I use the U direction. Okay, the U direction are these profiles. This one, I switch it to false. This one, I switch it to true. And this one, I switch it to true. And I see it's fine again. And now we have a good Gordon surface. That means all three helper surfaces are correct. Okay, and we have our head. Now we have to improve the head. The first thing what we do is that we, from this Gordon surface, first create the B-grid, and we create a map. So we always can look into the object and we can hide the Gordon surface. So we see this. And what we do as next is we unhide the sketches. So okay, now to get a tangent constraint here in this area, we have to modify this selected sketch. And what we need is we need that these two tangents are parallel. So if I make here a constraint, these two should be parallel, then I can smooth here in this direction. Okay, the next thing is the same here. In the other sketch, we already have this constraint. This is okay. So we can look for another condition. The other condition is both middle points should meet at the same place. We have a zenith point here. So I move this point here and up to the top. So I, oh, that's not correct. I move it here to the center. In this case, I get here the middle point of the surface. And the next thing what we now can do is we can also change some constraints of the border curve. We do not have a tangent constraint here. Is you see, if I have not a tangent constraint, I get here such a peak. So I only have to make these two parallel. And if I move the tangent indicators apart from the control point, I get a smooth interface. The same problem we have here. We delete this one. We can say here these two have to be parallel, and the same we have here on this corner. So I have to put this endpoint on this line. So now it will follow, and also we can have here such structure that we can track some detail outside the convex hull. This all is possible, but now we have on all positions smooth curves. So that's now our helmet in this situation. And that's all. So now we can look at the helmet. We hide the map. And what we see here is, I hide it once more, we see that the B grid is exactly the sketches here, the bearing sketches. So we can design our polygons that the resulting bearings fit some requirements, and then we get the helmet with has also these curves. Okay. Now I can hide all these helpers. I can hide all these sketches. I can hide the compound. And I have this structure, and I see here the Gordon surface, and now I can check the Gordon surface. It looks like this. Now I can also hide the B grid. So and I see this structure in this form here. So if I want to have not only tangent constraints but also a smooth curvature, I have to do further constraints. That mean I have to use here in this case condition that these points are symmetric. So now I have changed all this constraint here to symmetric ones here in these areas, and not always, but here in the main positions. And now the result is better, a smoother surface. There are still some small differences, but most parts are well balanced. So, next, what I want to demonstrate here is what happens if I change inside the sketches one into the other direction. In this case, I get this effect on the corner, and I also can move it here a little bit in this direction, and so on. And so we can get different kinds of heads. We also can make here it smaller. Up, now we have this format, and we can do the same here, smooth it, okay. So we are free to design different kinds of heads.